Bruce, you must have something really good too.
Of course I do. It's Bruce Danielson, and I guess I'm here to entertain you too.
Welcome to the first Sioux Falls Sings. I had this idea about 2 years ago, doing a community sing-along. And I met with our director of our symphony and pitched the idea to him, and he said he really liked it, but he said, Teresa, anytime our symphony members step outside to perform it, it's going to cost a minimum of $10,000. And so that wasn't going to, that door closed. And then this summer I got to thinking about it again, and I reached out to John Mogan, Mogan's Heroes. I said, John, what would you think about coming together to do something? And John does such a great job in the community, and he had just been at the 4th of July event and actually performed, I believe, the 11th, right? You were in the 11th. And I thought, wow, wouldn't this be neat to do something at the 11th, have people spread out on the grass, singing their hearts out in our community. And so John agreed, and then I contacted the Levitt and found out that that was really close to private entities. And the park department has a lot of fees that you have to pay, so that door kind of closed. Then I teach here at USF, so I called Jonathan Niederhauser. Kaiser, where's Jonathan? Well, he's back there. You can hear him directing his little orchestra. I said, Jonathan, what about having something on our campus and utilizing your chamber orchestra? Well, he thought that was pretty cool. And then I, of course, had known these wonderful guys here because they always perform at our Veterans Day services. And I thought, wow, wouldn't that be neat to bring them in as well? And have a variety of songs performed. So today, we're going to start out with the Star Spangled Banner. They're going to lead us. We're all going to sing, of course. And let me also say, I feel that we have in our community so many wonderful opportunities to listen. We hear performances a lot, but how often do we have participational things? We do in church, of course, but I'm talking about just a variety of songs. They're going to lead us in the Star Spangled Banner. John Mogan's group then is going to do a special, which is It Is Well With My Soul. Then they're going to lead us in some upbeat things. It'll be on the screen. I'll let John explain a little bit about that. And then we're going to have the Singing Legionnaires are going to lead us in some patriotic songs. And then we're going to have Jonathan Niederhauser's group lead us in some folk tunes. So it's all on the screen because we didn't want to have any added expense. But I thank USF so much because they made some beautiful posters. I thank Kello Land Living. They allowed us to come out. Some of you heard about it that way. I put something in the shopping news. KSFY had us on. It was a matter of trying to get the word out. I put it in some of your church bulletins. So I'm so grateful that you're here today, and I hope we're just going to have a wonderful time of raising our voices together in unity for our community. Thank you. And why don't we all stand for the Star Spangled Banner?
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose star stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the red
Sam, did you want to say a few words?
Sure. Hell, a few words. My friends Danny Gale on guitar, Bill Hoffman on drums. We've just celebrated our 41st anniversary of playing music. We started on Halloween night of 1978, beautiful downtown Chancellor, South Dakota. And I think we've gotten better. The people that were here earlier got to practice on the chorus, and all you have to do is sing with Bill. It is well with my soul.
So My arms. Boy, John, you know, it's a really good thing that they have those words up there for us. Because I've been singing most of those lyrics wrong for about 17 years now. Holy cow.
Yeah, we got a whole stage full of veterans. Other veterans, would you raise your hands, please? We always just a great job to you guys. Men and women. All the firefighters, police people that protect us, thank you so much.
If tomorrow all things were gone, work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife, I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, where the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take my thank you. Thank you.
Fabulous. Next, we have the USF Chamber Orchestra, a little more subdued, perhaps?
Not really.
Oh, not really. and we're coming now to the folk tune part. And you know, we've lost our folk tune sitting in our country a lot of time. We've lost our in sitting in our country. So, Jonathan, do you want to tell us what we're in for here?
Sure. First, we have a few treats for you. Dr. John Niederheiser, this is the University of Chicago Chamber Orchestra. In searching for some music for strings and flutes and piano, I stumbled across a set of pieces by Stephen Foster. Stephen Foster, don't know, one of America's greatest composers, a composer whose music, when you hear it, you think, oh, that's just a folk song, America. A lot of them wrote, like, Oh, Susanna, Down the Swanee River, and Old Folks Home. There's a lot of these songs, Campton Races. Very, very famous. This is actually dance music of 1856, so we got your top hits dance music of 1856. And two of the top dances they would have done were the quadrille. Does anyone have a quadrille? One of those ones. And a jig. This is from a whole set of chamber music that plays two of the tunes. A quadrille, the fourth one of the set, and a jig. And then we have a medley for you of four very familiar old standards. We have Oh Susanna, Home on the Range, Shenandoah, and You Are My Sunshine. And then at the end of that, we're going to bring out the whole group, and we're all going to sing that.
Let's get an A.
Bring
Oh.
so what does that have? Big relationship. Are you singing it two times, John? You're going to get sick at two times?
Yep.
That wasn't her. Okay. Let's hear it.
We have a round of applause also for Teresa.